Hello, this is Manuel York for the Leading People Follow-Up Program. Great that you are back. And again, you know, it's about reminding you of the tools you already know. It's about repetition. And the topic of this video today is be courageous, addressing resistance. So over the last weeks, you sharpened your perception to see signals, how people respond to you. Why was that important? Remember the purpose story. You at the very beginning of the purpose story, you start the process and you want to make sure that people want to engage in order to create cycles of value, opposite to cycles of waste. And you at the very beginning, you are so to speak at crossroads where basically it's decided whether the purpose story goes into the right direction and creates the right dynamic. Now, after starting that process, you receive signals. Now assume you get negative signals, signals of resistance. What are you going to do with them? There's one thing for sure, and this is what we see every time, all the time in life, that people have a tendency to avoid to do something because we know now addressing this becomes uncomfortable. And because we don't know what we might cause, we create a certain concern, sometimes even a fear of uncertain outcomes. Now, what we want to do is we want to overcome that. And we overcome this by anticipating the consequences. And this is, again, reminding you of the tools we already talked about and you already trained them and you already experienced them. So now someone responds with resistance. What can you do? What you can do is to address it. And again, for addressing, we have this four-phrase tool. It is, I see something, I see you, I wonder. Then you start asking questions and you ask a closing question to close that format. So let's assume you want someone something to do and you don't get a positive response immediately, but the person kind of frowns and you sense there is some resistance. And wait a moment and then you can address it. Very simple. You address what you see. You can say, hey, wait a minute. What I see is a frown on your face. And then you wait a moment. The other person now realizes that his behavior, his unconscious facial expressions don't get unnoticed. Now he starts self-reflecting. And what the person then will do inwardly is to agree to what you said. Yeah, it's true, I'm frowning. And you will get a yes or a yes kind of signal. Then after these 2-3 seconds, just a small moment, you continue. Instead of appreciating if you see something positive, you would then say, wait a minute, I'm surprised. I don't understand that. Second phrase, wait a moment. And then you can continue and ask, like, you know, I would like to understand what's on your mind. This is the third phrase. And then you could close, you don't need to close with that, but you could close with a closing question, which would sound like, is that okay for you? Now, the other person has to respond. So the uncomfortable situation now is totally on the other side. Now the other person has to say something, has to show something, to express something, and to kind of reveal what's on his mind. And then you take it from there. Assume that the response is somehow negative again, like, I don't want to talk about it. Then you do the same thing. First sentence is, hey, wait a minute, what I just asked you a question, and what I see is that you say, I don't want to talk about that with you. Short break. Then again, say, I don't understand that. Short pause. And then tell me more. What's on your mind? Is that okay that I ask that? Now, if you repeat that, assume, step into the shoes of that other person. If you repeat that for, let's say, 2-3 times, what choice does the other person then have but to respond and to somehow reveal what's on his mind? And now you have all these blockers that before your intervention, before asking the question, before addressing, all these emotional or mental blockers that were on the inside of the other person are now on the table, and now you can deal with it. And that's it. That's what I would like you to test for the next days. Again, I'm not testing you. What I would like you to do is to test the tools. And this time, it requires a bit more courage to address unpleasant signals. So with this, I'm looking forward to learning about your experiences. So see you next time. This is Manuel York for the Leading People Follow-Up Program.